NYC in Calgary. I'm Michelle Sklar, here with Patrick Finn, who is a professor at U of C. Secretly, we've been calling the love doctor, but Patrick was one of our presenters here at the event. So, just to back up a little bit, Tell us a little bit about what you do at University of Calgary.
Well, I offer these big, huge classes that are designed to appeal to students from every single department on campus, and we have them all there. And we talk about big issues that are current for people today. So we have a course on creativity, one on story, one on happiness, and one on love, as you pointed out. Yeah.
Okay. So one of the things that you made very, very, I think, crystal clear in my mind anyways, is that the course on love is really not about fluff and baskets. It's not about, some pop psychology. It really is about how we communicate.
Yes.
So talk to us a little bit more on some of the higher level points you were hoping that the audience picked up on today.
Oh, okay, sure, fantastic. I think, for example, with the love class, you're talking about a topic that is the most written about topic in the world. And what I would argue is that right now, we bring these students together in a room to talk about it. The students of today are far more talented, far more informed than any we've encountered so far. They're already so informed by all the information that they can get on their own that when they come in, they're ready to really sort of have not a debate where it's fighting back and forth, but a sharing of information so that we can find new ideas and come up with new combinations and things like that and really develop what I think is the next way of thinking. This is the next evolution of thinking.
You know, it's interesting when you are talking about sort of the days of critical thinking. I think about my university days and that the courses that were being offered were really about critical thinking,
yes.
Postmodernism, you know, all that good stuff, which back then, I say back then, I'm dating myself, but back then, those really were novel, outside-of-the-box ideas. And now we're hearing from you, it's time to think differently. Well, are we not asking a lot of people to, you know, want to be less critical? Are we not asking a lot of people to not want to maybe look at things in a little bit more of a challenging way? I mean, we talk about some of the global events. We even saw, a TED video on how one person can really generate a movement because it was really about looking at the world and seeing that something is not right. So how do you balance being an effective communicator with being an effective activist?
Okay, well, in terms of the communication, it's a really dynamic set of communication that I'm talking about. I'm not talking about something where we pretend that everything is sort of lovely in that. The notion of loving thinking is actually opening yourself to the other speaker. So what happens is the dynamic should become much more active. And so what happens then is we're able to listen to those who we disagree with as well, but then say, let's bring more information to the table. So what we're experimenting with now is that the idea that critical thinking itself was too linear and was too narrow, and that now in a global world, in a world with all of the new brain science things that are telling us about how interrelated we are, about this technological revolution, all of these things coming together, we literally have to become different beings. Our brains have to rewire themselves in a whole new way. And it's not difficult because the surprise, or what I've seen at the university, is it's already happening. We're already doing it. TEDsters are doing it. University students that I'm teaching today, they're already doing it. What we're looking at is the greatest shift in the way that the mind works since print.
Right.
So in more than 1,000 years.
So my last question for you, one of the things that we hope to inspire people today, I don't have my name tag on, but we're bringing back Polaroid, and we have Polaroid snapshots of everybody here,
right.
And we've asked them to put the community that they live in and something that they either would like to see more of in Calgary or something that they really appreciate in Calgary. So what community do you live in?
I live in the Northwest,
okay.
right by the university.
Okay. Is there anything about what you're seeing happening in your community that you really like or that maybe you're inspired to get more engaged with?
Oh, this is so easy. I was so proud of the mayoral election in our city. And the reason is, it's not about Ned Nenshi winning, that was tremendous, but it was about Barb Higgins and Rick McIver and Ned Nenshi not going negative, debating issues, talking about the future, doing forward motion. We can learn a lot from them. And I felt just so proud to be a Calgarian, I still do, because of how wonderful all of those people were. They should be applauded. I want more of that, more elections like that.
Awesome. Patrick, thank you so much for joining us. Patrick Finn, who is a university professor at the U of C. We're at TEDxYYC at the Grand. I'm Michelle Sklar.